Welcome back to my Let's Play of Amnesia, a Machine for Pigs.
Come on, Snow Coach, it's this way.
Attempts to clear the floodwaters. Treachery, Mandus. We were undone. Your children are trapped by this act. You must find them before it is too late.
What do you need me to do? How can I find them?
Always deeper, Mandus. Through the piston room and into the tunnels. Then find the bilge and flush the rotten water. I will help you where I can. But you must be swift, my little friend.
Legs about me. Damn this wretched soul. I am given birth to nothing but machinery.
Thank you. still. For God's sake, hold still, child. Don't let it get into your eyes. I'm going to rinse it out now. There. It will be fine. You just need to lie down. Enoch, look for your brother. How many times have I told you not to play in the cellar?
Extraordinary, quite extraordinary. And you built it all. Good God, man, you have been busy.
It is wonderful how tragedy focuses the mind. What else was I to do? Fall into grief, pine, and fade in my hopelessness? Why not then simply die in that jungle amongst those dead temples?
Then, what if they could stand upright and walk as men? What if the brute were harnessed thus? What would they sing? Would they find their own god? I have seen these things, and I will tell you now, no. No, they will not. But they will happily accept featly to a god thrust upon them and worship it thus given. In this, I realize they are no different to the masses. They're much the same as us. Once this irrevocable threshold is passed, I understand that we too are shackled and must be set free. To free the man, we cut the man. In order to cross that great evolutionary line, it must first be painted upon the ground. In America, they talk of building their own cities to the skies. To me, this seems folly, but perhaps it is simply a case of a nation founded without a history of its own. We walk upon our histories. They are compacted into the very loam beneath our feet. The engineers we employed talk of this. They talk of how, when we build underground trains, they would often come across older tunnels, crisscrossing the capital. What palace lie buried beneath us? We are digging, digging, excavating, reappropriating what we find. At the center of the planet, my architect tells me, there is a great iron ball. Is this the egg of the world? All the suggestions of a large workforce, yet no actual signs of life. It is every bit as if someone has attempted to carefully create the illusion of a working factory complex, yet this facade, when examined closely, is clearly just a falsification. But I must put my anxieties, quell uneasiness that pits my stomach, and continue on my path. Further soothe the product. We find Debussy particularly effective in this regard. Rutting carelessly, ejaculating their feet. filthy little missives into the streets, alleys, and gutters, running freely with the careless spill of their conjoinings, an air thick with the whimperings of lust, bodies streaked with their own emissions. We have created a world where man is so utterly debased, he will spray his seed over a passerby. And yet, this is condition Babbage aspired to. No, this is not the machines we seek. Such an entity should be nothing less than a deity, and we would fall upon our knees and worship it. We shall not carve gods to bicker and fornicate. They will exist to clean the world and set us free. I reject Babbage, and I reject these men of the government. Let the pigs copulate in the gutters whilst they can. We shall scoop them up and ease their ascension soon enough.
Papa, let's climb this one. I can see more pictures at the top.
This canister looks as if it may fit into the fuel pump we saw earlier. It certainly carries the same fetid, unholy reek. I will not think of that which I saw pass me in its cage. I will not gaze again into that dark machine room. A more immediate task presents itself, and the opportunity, perhaps, to gain access to St. Dunstan's. Dear sweet lord of all that is good and holy, I must make my escape. Grasp this container and its putrid contents and flee the place for the creature that nearly man returns. I will head to the church. Surely such an abomination could not follow to the hallowed ground. How in blazes are we supposed to meet in these damned schedules if even the basic equipment are provided simply not will not perform to the design designated functions? These cursed new fangled trucks will only run a fraction of the distance my old nag managed before running out of stinking gasoline. These gaffers say it's fine, and there's plenty of pumps to refill them outside of the factory walls, but you end up dragging these blessed tanks from truck to the nearest one to refill it. And the one in the storeroom is empty again. I can't be returning to that crank handle all day only to find the tank is empty. Well, sod it, says I. Enough for a night. And to bed I go.
This way, Papa. Come and see. Will it hatch? Can we take it home?
Yes, my darling. Of course we can take it home.
Thank you.
flock to us now, where once I had to walk amongst them, to bring salvation to their lives. Now drawn by warmth and winter, by the food that Mandus distributes, my church is full, my charges are saved. He walks amongst them, and they almost worship him. He will not allow them to work in his factories, claiming that his factories are specifically trained for the new machinery he uses, and that it would be irresponsible, nay, unethical, to risk precious lives as he sees here. A changed man since Mexico. It is to be praised that in the face of such appalling tragedies, and from the confines of his sickbed, as he is often chained to, he conducts one of the greatest and most benevolent charities in all of London. Not content with the rise to become the dominant food produce business in the land, he distributes his goodwill, his fares to the poor, and they congregate about his kingdom in gratitude.